I hope that you and your family are safe in this difficult time and taking care of everyone in your family against the pandemic. The world has passed through a very difficult time from last 1 year, and India is not an option out of it. And India has passed in a difficult time and now is passing in a more difficult time and a more challenging time. And everyone has to take care of themselves. They have to take care of the recoveries if they are affected by the pandemic. And the globe has to do the same. And I think everyone is taking care of each other as well as the society and following the strict guidelines given by the government. I want to thank all our team members for delivering a lifetime high result in this difficult time. At the same time, I want to thank all our key investors who have stood by us in putting confidence in the management in this difficult time also. We all know that we have more challenges with each day, with the pandemic still continuing, a lot of challenges coming our way due to the pandemic as well as the vaccination program also will take its own time. For Astral, myself, I am not taking care of my own family, but I am being taking care of the Astral family as a whole and the families of my country, which is very near and dear to me. And whatever we can do in this difficult time, we are doing the contribution to this society. We have done our level best to get our staff members vaccinated at the office, at the factory. At the office, we are almost 80 to 90% office has been vaccinated. At the factory, mostly 50% plus people have been vaccinated. So we have taken a very vigorous vaccination drive, and the same drive still continues at our plants and at the factory. For the CSR and what has to be done for the society, we have done our best to help many hospitals with equipment, BiPAP equipment, the oxygen concentrators, and many other medicines. As well as we have ensured that all our staff members who have been affected by the pandemic should be given the best treatment, not only to them, but their family members and their children. And not a single rupee should be spent from their own pocket to get them recovered. But still, unfortunately, we lost a few people in the organization whom I will remember lifelong. And to take care of their families and their children, we have declared to give them the running salary, the cost to the company for 2 years and education to their children till they reach the college. This is what we have been doing for the our own people, and we'll keep doing the best for them and their families and spouses. And if there are ladies, we for their husbands. We as Astral have come forth to put 2 oxygen plants at our Santej location. 2 oxygen plants of 30 meter cube. I don't know exactly what is the number meter cube or what it is, but like, will be in this week and will be operational by next week. And we can daily fill 250 oxygen cylinders, which are used in these hospitals. And in nutshell, taking care of 250 to 300 individuals for their need for oxygen. So a lot of these initiatives And a lot of these initiatives have been done, and a lot of these initiatives are being continued. We are continuing to do so to help our society and help our country in this difficult time. Coming to the business part, let me first step into the pipe business. The performance, the numbers of the business will be obviously discussed by Hiranand Saab, our Chief Financial Officer, and our family member, I can say very proudly. But to first brief you, there have been balancing expansion plans going on at every factory. Started, we did automation at many levels. We increased the certain capacities of higher range of fittings by getting new molds. And we put up a facility to make water tanks. The water tank facility at Santej is operational, and that is the number two facility after the Aurangabad facility, which we acquired a few months back. And we have started rolling out and sales of the plastic tanks, astral tanks, from the Santej location. We will be starting our pipe tank manufacturing at the Gilor plant in Rajasthan shortly, and then followed by the tank manufacturing at the Hosur plant in South also shortly, within next span of 3 to 4 months maximum. These will be two more facilities added to the two existing facilities of Aurangabad and Santej. The construction work of the valve manufacturing is being completed at Dholka. We have started basic range of valves, both in plumbing as well as in industry. And with each passing month, there will be new molds and new additions happening in this facility. We would also proudly say that we will be the first Indian company making its own compound for fire sprinkler, Fire Pro, and our compound and pipe will be the first product indigenously made, approved by UL. UL is the highest approval for the fire sprinkler pipes, other than FM and LPCB. Those approvals are also underway. So we will be having all the international approvals, but we are now approved by UL. So we are in line with the products made globally and in the developed countries, and have the approval of UL other than the ISI approval of India. At Santej, we worked for almost 2 years to revamp the technology of CPVC, aluminum CPVC pipe. And we just launched that product a few days back and called it Multifrost. In past, we are making this product, but due to reasons, we had to stop the production. We worked on the advanced technology, we worked on improvements in technology, we worked on the improvement of the product for almost 2 years, and with all things in line, we have launched this product a few days back, and it is an excellent market because this technology globally is at present only with Astral and manufactured by only Astral. Globally, we are the first and the only manufacturer of CPVC composite pipe. And it has extensive use, extensive market, extensive application. And the good part of our technology is the cost effectiveness of the product is much, much better than what we used to manufacture in the past. So we have made the product more cost effective to expand its usage in the plumbing as well as a lot of other applications. So this product is through from Santej. In the plant set Aurangabad and Sangli. Our PVCC PVC machines are there, and we have started manufacturing PVC agri and SWR pipes from Sangli. Shortly, we will be starting manufacturing of CPVC, PVC, agri and SWR pipes from Aurangabad. In next Q2, this will be operational. Sangli PVC is already operational. The Bhubaneswar work is in full swing. The project should be completed in September 21, and the production will be rolled out in October 21. This is a state-of-the-art plant designed to go up to 60,000 metric ton. The first phase will be 20,000 metric ton. So Bhubaneswar will be operational in before this year end. And all the plants in Maharashtra will be making CPVC, PVC, SWR agri to cater the Maharashtra market as well as the Central India market with cost effectiveness. There are value expansions going on. There are certain value expansion product developments going on. Certain products are developed, but COVID is delaying us in some way or the other for the launching of these products. But we will be launching another new product line in Q1 or Q2 in the piping industry, in the piping business. And our team has been continuously working on these developments and launching of new products. And we at our level, at management level, are also continuously involved in developing new technologies and seeking new opportunities in the Indian market for the infrastructure people. So overall pipe has, the results are there, that is a growth, there is all these challenges, we have done our best. And again, I congratulate the team, and a lot of initiatives to go ahead are underway. And we are also working on setting up our own R&D facilities and technology transfer facilities as well as training facilities at Sape. And it should be true in next one and a half years if we are not more delayed by the COVID. Coming to the adhesive business, Resinova, as we had always told, there were a lot of challenges one and a half years back, as you all know. We overcame the challenges. We again completed our task of revamping things, and we kept on appraising you all, and we always kept you in the loop. And last few quarters, I've been telling you that things are in line, and you will see the numbers will reflect. And obviously, the numbers are reflecting. Resinova's performance was excellent under this difficult time. The results are in front of you. And we have almost grown at 93% in Q4 year-on-year basis, the highest in the history of Resinova. And I am confident that going forward, we'll keep this performance, we'll keep this run rate, and we'll keep sharing you new developments in Resinova. A lot of new developments are taking place in Resinova, and a lot of new product addition is taking place in Resinova, in the construction chemical business, in the wood segment, in the maintenance segment, and we are also getting into a lot of other chemistries. The R&D facility at Resinova is under expansion. We are doubling the facility, and it will be operational in next 2 to 3 months. The work is almost under the completion of the R&D facility. The plants are, whatever the balance equipments or whatever the safety aspects, things have to be done, are continuously done at the 3 plants, 2 at Kanpur and 1 at Ahmedabad. We have kick-started initial work at Dahej, and it would be a phase-wise plant. We'll be making the plant in phase manner, and it will take at least one and a half years to have a state-of-art plant at Dahej for certain chemistries, and with the state of art safety and automation. So that work has started. We have entrusted the work to one of the best consulting firms of India who have designed many chemical plants, and the work is just started in a phased manner. And we, as pandemic allows us to speed up the thing, accordingly the work will go on at the Dahej plant for retinol. The business outlook is excellent in adhesive, and we are very positive for this business, and we are very positive about the growth and the future of the adhesive business in the Astral family. We have launched a series of new products in the Resinova. We have launched new Solvopon premium range, Resiwood Edge and Vesta D3, TrueBuilt. We have launched PU, TrueBuilt APC, then we have launched all the rubber adhesives. We have crack fillers, we have bond set, we have many, many chemistries where we were not present, or we were just minuscule, or where we needed to upgrade, or where we needed to have the better technology, as we have done the same and have done the added these products to the market from Resinova table. We are also working for few new chemistries with UK as our company in R&D center, as well as the R&D center in Ahmedabad. And we will be also adding few products in coming quarters, and we'll keep you updated on this as we move forward in the new product category. Now coming to the Sealit UK and US business. UK, as everyone knows, is almost out of pandemic, and now it has declared, the first country to declare COVID as a disease, not a pandemic. And the growth trajectory now would be even better than what we have done. But in this challenging time of COVID, UK, which is a country of a lot of challenge of growth, it is a developed country, but the Sealit has given a 16% plus growth, an excellent growth, remarkable growth, and a remarkable double-digit EBITDA has been given by the Sealit, though the raw material was under inflation. The US is doing very good. It is on itself, it is making profits, it is growing, especially the rescue tape business is growing excellently well. But we launched a few products for roof sealing, hybrid products from UK, which are made in UK in US market, and the response is enormous. We are exporting containers worth product to US. We have been approved by the big Home Depots and Kraus and many other such stores, and we have been placing our products one by one in these stores, and the roof sealing hybrid products are exported from UK to US, and we are getting a good chunk of business there. And in future, if the same level of business continues, we may plan to make some more product lines in US, which are made in UK, to cater the market and to have a bigger growth in the US market. So, overall, Astral as a family in this time of pandemic has done its best to take care of the business, to take care of the growth, to take care of the profit, to take care of the people and its investors. And we'll continue to do so in the coming years, coming months. And we are still working at our highest peak and highest level, even in the month of April. And even this month also, we are working whatever the best we can to give growth and cater to the market and take care of the society. So with this, I thank you all, and we'll answer more when you have your questions about your any of the things you want to know more about the business and other aspects. Till then, I pass on the mic to Hiranand Savlani to continue his interest to all of you. Thank you, everyone.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for joining this con call, and hope you all are safe. And we wish that we all come out quickly from this pandemic and move to our regular activities, and we take our country to the fast vaccination drive so that we can be coming out much faster way. We are thankful to Astral team, which has supported us for this, and particularly to the HR team, which has taken care of vaccination work, and that is why we all seniors are safe, and we all are double vaccinated now. And we wish that whatever the left out portion of the team members are there, HR is sincerely taking care of all of them, and shortly they will also be getting vaccinated, and we all will be coming out from this pandemic. Now this press release is with you, so I will not take much number because we already taken a sizable time, so I will try to give more time to the Q&A session. But I will highlight a few things which we have taken place in this quarter and going forward, what is our plan and what is our growth strategy. So few of the points I will highlight and then we will move to the Q&A session. So this quarter was the one of the excellent quarter in the history of the Astral, in which not only we have grown up the business in the piping, which deliver us close to about 80% top line growth on quarter basis. It is a mix of little lower base also last year. There is some advantage of, you can say, the major advantage I can say is because of the polymer price. And secondly, the genuine demand was also robust in this quarter. And that is why it is not only the top line growth, but in the volume terms also, we have grown close to about 36%. So in all respect, this quarter was excellent. And we were running shortages in many of the items. And we were of the view that if this run rate will continue, in the coming quarter will be very, very robust to us. Because a lot of shift is taking place from unorganized to organized side. But unfortunately, the second wave has come. So little bit activities have get go slow, but we are quite confident the moment again this country will reopen, we will maintain a higher growth rate in the coming quarters also. Taking to the adhesive side, adhesive was also one of the best quarters as we said in the history of the Reginova and the Shilid. Both have delivered an excellent number, and that is why you can see that the revenue growth of the last quarter was 73%. And there, the base effect of UK was not problematic, but yes, definitely Reginova was not low. So that has also to some extent supported, but 73% kind of growth is unbelievable kind of growth our team has achieved. Not only the growth of 73%, but our EBITDA growth was 150%, which is very, very remarkable. And that gives us the confidence what we have communicated earlier to you guys, that ultimately the goal of Astral is to take this adhesive business to 16% plus EBITDA growth percentage level, at which we are already going towards that journey. And we are quite confident that in next 3 years time, we will be 16% plus EBITDA company into the adhesive and the sealant business also. On a consolidated basis, similar, because both the businesses have equally delivered the good numbers. Because of that, the revenue growth was 79% on a Y basis. And on a full year basis also, we delivered on a console basis 23% top line growth. And EBITDA was doubled in the top line growth. Top line was 23%, EBITDA growth was 46%. And equally the strong PBT number of 74%. So in nutshell, the numbers were very robust and the economy was going at a very, very rapid pace, and the kind of growth we were getting was tremendous. And we are of the view the underlying current is still very strong in the economy, and the housing sector is performing very well. And you can see the housing sales number also, that India normally do around 65,000 unit quarterly run rate, which we have already crossed in the last quarter. India has sold 69,000 units of housing in the particularly top 9 cities. The market demand in the pipe segment was robust from September onward, and that moment is still continue till last quarter. Even April was comparatively good. Volume growth was a single digit, but top line growth was 50% compared to FY19, because FY20 number will be the misleading number. So that's why we have given in the press release also comparison with FY19. Similarly, in the adhesive business also, demand was excellent from July onward, and it continued throughout the last quarter, and equally good number we see in the April also. The best part we seen in the adhesive was both India operation as well as UK operation did excellent work in Q4. And we are confident that going forward also, this momentum will continue post this small hiccup which has come from the second wave. There was a huge pressure of raw material inflation in both the businesses, in adhesive as well as in pipe business. But pipe we were able to pass on quickly, while adhesive we have passed on with the lag effect. And that is why slight drop is there into our GP margin in adhesive business. But otherwise, in the pipe business, we are maintaining our GP margin also. And all these numbers will be uploaded on the stock exchange's website, because we have prepared a very nice, beautiful presentation. But unfortunately, yesterday there was a cyclone effect in Ahmedabad, so many part of the city was disconnected from this Wi-Fi and the mobile connectivity, and the lights were not there. So our team was not able to complete that fast presentation. But I'm sure that my team will be able to complete today, and by late evening, maybe 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock, we will be uploading that presentation. It was final touch to be given by me, because I was throughout the day was busy with the media and on calls from the fund managers and analyst community. So we were not able to finish, but I'm promising you that you will be getting this presentation from our side by late evening, by 8 to 9 o'clock. As communicated earlier, that the growth side in the coming time, like 3 to 5 years, will be very, very robust. And we are standby to that, and the margin will also be much, much better. Normal margin in the pipe industry, you know, 15% kind to 16% kind of sustainable margin. But now consistently last 6 to 8 quarters, Astral is delivering much, much higher margin than the normal margins of 15% kind of run rate. So now we are of the view that this higher run rate will be little bit inch up in the coming times also, though there may be a pressure on the downward side on the PVC side. But at the same time, good part is that the CPVC prices have started inching up now, and across the industry, everybody has taken the price rise of between 5 to 8%. So the Astral has taken the price rise in the CPVC. So that will support the downfall of the PVC price. And Astral, you all know that it's generating the maximum revenue from the CPVC side. Intra business was good pickup in the Q4, and the numbers were encouraging. So we are of the view that the way government has promised to spend sizable money into the infra side, if that is the run rate will continue in the coming year, I think in the coming quarter, infra business should do better for us. Numbers are with you, so you all know that Astral is sitting with a very, very handsome cash on hand, that is close to about 476 crore rupees. Even at the net level also, after deducting the debt also, we are sitting on a net basis a cash of 409 crore. So robust cash flow is coming to us, and we are expecting in another couple of years, we will be crossing more than 1,000 crore cash flow. During the year, company has done a capex of 167 crore rupees, and which include the acquisition of this tank business, which where we spent close to about 45-50 crore rupees, and we have added a capacity of 19,000 metric ton plus. Balance sheet quality, as you know, we are continuously communicating in every our communication, every our con call, that Astral is very, very serious about the quality of the balance sheet, and we have demonstrated in this quarter also. That you can see that in this quarter also, in spite of so much of challenges were there, we did a handsome growth of 78-79% on a full year basis, 23-24%. But still we have maintained our working capital cycle. Not only we have maintained, but we have reduced our working capital cycle. You can see the inventory days, which had come down from 77 to 54 days. And our working capital cycle on a console basis has come down from 41 to 27. So our working capital has also given us the additional operating cash flow for us. As far as this opportunity in which Astral is there, you know we are into right now into four segments. That is the pipe, infra, adhesive, and the tank. Pipe opportunity in India is roughly about 33,000 crore, 32 to 33,000 crore. Infra is close to about more than 1,000 crore opportunity. Adhesive in India, roughly about 15,000 crore opportunity, and 14,000 crore opportunity in UK. And tank business is roughly about 5,000 crore opportunity. So all put together, Astral is right now working in an area where the market opportunity is roughly about 67,000 crore rupees. No need to write this number, because everything, these numbers are already there in the presentation, which you will get post-con call. So pipe, we are roughly about 7 to 7.5% of the market share. Adhesive, India, we have a hardly 3-4% market share, and UK, we have a close about 2% kind of market share. And tank, we are just going to begin our journey. So huge, huge, I can say, potential is there in the coming next 5 to 10 years for the growth. And we are expecting, if we work hard, we can double the size of our top line in next 5 years' time. At the same time, we are working on the new product also, and you will find the list of the new product which we have launched in the each and every category of Astral. Sandeep Bhai has already discussed about this multi-pro, when we have launched the water tank also in the adhesives. Every category we have launched the new product with the advanced technology and the advanced chemistry, whether it is the construction chemical, PVA, you can say the epoxy side, even a solvent cement also, we have launched a premium categories of solvent cement into the adhesive basket. And we will continue this kind of launching in the coming quarter, because sizable, I think, product range is there in the pipeline, which our R&D team is working, and Sandeep is spending more money into the R&D side, and he has put up a very, very state-of-art building of R&D into the Reginova. And unfortunately, this is not a good time to invite all of you, but I will wish that the moment this things will settle down, we will invite all of you to visit our facility and see the kind of R&D facility we have put up in Ahmedabad. We are also open for the growth, whether it is inorganic or organic, because now the sizable cash is there and the sizable cash flow is expected in the coming time. So we are always ready for the both side, organic as well as inorganic side. And but our criteria will remain same, and we will maintain that discipline that any business which will not going to give us 20% ROC, we will not look into that kind of businesses. And we will be looking only profitable businesses and businesses which can leverage our brand Astral, as well as it can leverage our distribution network of dealer and distributor, which is a huge, huge network. More than 33,000 kind of dealers in pipe business and more than 130,000 dealers into the adhesive basket. So we have a very, very huge family. They can sell product, we are ready to bring that product into our basket, and we will keep continuously introducing these kind of products. Now, coming to the pipe side again, as you know that the shift from unorganized to organized side is getting momentum, and we are of the view the second wave will be further getting into more accelerated way. And still we all know that 35% kind of 30-35% is unorganized trade into the piping sector. So this is going to be a good driver for the growth for Astral. Secondly, we all already communicated that Astral is moving from the human approach to the systemic approach concept. And that is why we are strengthening our system at the head office level as well as at the market level. And now this Astral loyalty program is getting momentum in the market. You will be surprised to know that now every month we are getting sizable new plumbers adding into that program, and many new dealers are getting joined into this program. And in this pandemic time, we have supported every our plumber brothers and our dealers by way of transfer of their money into the Paytm account, so that they can get in and in this difficult time. So they need not to worry about their whatever their points are there, they can immediately convert and we can transfer the money to their PPM account. And we would sizably transfer that money during this pandemic time also. As communicated, Sandeep Bhai, East plant is gearing up, and hopefully we are targeting to be ready by September. So October onward, the delivery will start in the market. And as you know that our competitors are very, very strong into this size of the geography, but our stake is very low into that. So we are expecting that the moment our plant will be ready, we will be saving a huge amount of logistic cost, which will help us to strengthen our geographical reach into the eastern market, and we will be delivering a good number in the coming times over there. Same way, government projects, we know that the kind of amount government has communicated in the budget and the various forum, whether it is a Jal Sanal, whether it is a affordable housing, whether it is an infrastructure project, they all will keep supporting the Astral product. And we are quite confident that Astral will also participate in these kind of, not directly by bidding process, but definitely we will be supporting our dealers and distributor community to support at the local level, panchayat level, or maybe a municipality level, wherever the project requires these kind of products. You all know that with every growth, we are always believing in decentralizing ourselves and de-risking ourselves. So as a part of that, we are continuously going to de-risk our business. So this year, we are adding the 3 locations of pipe. That is in Sangli, we are adding the pipe as well as Aurangabad and this Bhuneshwar, that is in East. So 3 new locations in the pipe is going to be added in the current year. Similarly, as communicated earlier also, I am repeating again that Astral's continuous focus will be there into the value-added products, and we will continue to add the value-added product in our basket. And valve product is little bit delayed, but many valves have already started production in our existing plant, but the new building is almost on the verge of completion, and then the new machines and all will and mold will are on the way. So hopefully we are targeting that the Q2 new building will start producing the varieties of valve, and that will be rolled out from the Q3 in the market. Adhesive and sealant side also, growth is there continuously, and we are expecting that this moment will continue, and this will be further supported by the new product launch which we have recently done, and new additional product which shortly going to be launched in the coming time. And the US, as Sandeepai has already discussed, it will be a good growth driver for our overseas operation. If that product will click, the numbers will be really fantastic for us. So right now we have exported maybe 15-20 containers, and they have given a good support to us, and now we are thinking to retake over there that product exporting from UK, and with the further growth we are going to start producing at the US plant itself. The plastic storage tank, I think little delayed this project, but now we are ready with the 2 plant, Aurangabad, and because acquisition side also got some delayed because you know this is the pandemic time, so some paper formalities and that takes always time. So we have completed the complete acquisition process in the month of March, and now we are ready and we are geared to take the challenge of the market, and now we will be pushing our product into the market. And similarly, Ahmedabad plant will also support because now Ahmedabad is ready with the tank. And shortly, the 2 new locations will be added, that is Ghiloth and then subsequently Hosur. And at the last, we are going to add that into the our eastern plant. With this, I want to conclude my initial remark and open the floor for the Q&A session. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Even now, we're in the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question, you press star and 1 on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and 2. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We would also request the participants to please limit your questions to 2 per participant. The first question is from the line of Nitin Jain from Fairview Investment Advisors. Please go ahead.
So thank you, sir, for the opportunity. And first of all, congratulations on the excellent set of numbers. So I have 2 questions related to the adhesive segment. So in this quarter, the market leader has seen their margins drop sharply due to raw material inflation, but we have managed to improve our margins quarter on quarter and year on year. So is there any particular reason for this outperformance? And related to and the other question is the waterproofing market, like the market leader is seeing it as the next leg of growth. So how are we present there? Because every quarter we see paint companies gaining market share and the market leader also gaining market share. So how aggressive are we here? Thank you.
So I think I agree with your understanding that there was a huge pressure on the raw material side, and the same thing was with us. In initial remark also I communicated that there was some pressure on the GP level. But because we did about 73% offline growth, so because of economy of scale, we were able to improve our margin. Not only reduction in the margin, but there is an improvement into the margin. So basically, economy of scale has supported us in this difficult time. And at the same time, with lag effect, we have passed on to the market. And thanks to Touchwood, we are not in a big way presence. Our volume in the PVA is still very, very low. So it has not affected too much to us because our other products have performed very well. So because of that, there was no pressure on the margin. But yes, margin pressure is still there because still the raw material prices are on a higher side. But Touchwood, we are passing off with the lag effect and the top line growth is high. So because of that, there is no pressure on the EBITDA. And on the contrary, in this difficult time, we have increased our EBITDA margin. Regarding your second question to the waterproofing, yes. Everyone is talking about the waterproofing and there will be a very, very big market opportunity into that front. So every player definitely is going to perform in this market. When the market size is big, when the market size is big, everyone else can take a small piece of the cake. Larger player or maybe a leader can take away the bigger chunk of cake. But there is always an opportunity available for the smaller size companies also to take some portion of that. So that is the case with us also. So with the time, we are also continuously launching new products into the waterproofing side. In my presentation, which is shortly going to be uploaded in the site, you will see a new product which we have launched with the waterproofing side also. So keep finger crossed. We'll keep adding the product basket into that segment also and we'll keep growing at a higher rate.
And with the plumber data which we have, and as we are in the construction industry, in the plumbing business with the plumbers, the connection with the plumbers, lot of our waterproofing products will be launched with new initiatives and which will help us to grow. Because we have all the products in line, we have all the chemistries, we have all the products available, and we need to go and touch the end users, and that programs are being worked out, rolled out. And we also equally see a great opportunity in waterproofing business, and we'll give you a good set of numbers in this segment and this business in coming years. And very soon we'll be growing very well in this segment. And we have a lot of initiatives with the plumbers and a lot of end users is going on in the water. So it was a good question, and I think we are very positive on this.
Mr. Savlani mentioned about the lag effect. So, should we see any pressure on the adhesive margins in this quarter? Or the price hike will take care of it?
Yeah, this quarter, April was good, I can say, but May is still slow because of the majority of the country passing through this pandemic time and the lockdowns and all those things. So, top line growth will be low compared to what we originally planned. Of course, it will be better than the last year Q1. The last year April was affected. This year May is affected. But one thing is good that there is no complete shutdown. So that is a good part that at least some sale is happening today also. So that is going to support us. But I think one quarter or maybe 1 month or 2 months is not a right way to look at any company. We have to see any company's performance from the next 5 year point of view. And we always guide our investors that don't look our quarterly number, because quarterly number, one quarter may be abnormal, one quarter may be subdued because of the market condition and all. But you have to see the annual number. You see, in this difficult time, you rightly said that the peers are not able to grow top line and Astral was able to grow 26% top line growth. That itself shows that we believe in the long-term journey and we are, whatever steps we are taking, that is taking from the point of view of long-term. Not from the one quarter point of view. So I humbly request every investor, it will be misleading if you continuously look at the quarterly number. Always look at the annual number and the next 5 year number.
Thank you. We would request the current participant to please come back in the question queue for any follow-up questions, as we have several participants waiting for their turn. The next question is from the line of Sujit Jain from ASK Investment Managers Limited. Please go ahead.
Sandeep Bhai and Savlani Ji, congratulations. Very delighted with the numbers. A quick question on now the industry size, you spelled out 32,000 crores, that is for pipes. But in terms of volume, what do you think would be the industry size? and roughly the split between CPVC and PVC. And clearly you have made some solid gains in terms of market share. What your current PVC, CPVC market share would stand? Any inventory gains this quarter, if you can quantify? And generally to understand our cost structure compared to other CPVC players, how much extra in terms of operating margins you will be earning because you make your own CPVC compound? Thank you.
So let's start with the last question first. That CPVC compound, what is the advantage to us? I think I will not be in a position to quantify because of the competitiveness in the market. But definitely, anybody who is making the compound, and now Astral team has got a mastery in making the compound. Today, any raw material regime of the world, we can compound in our plant. So that is the strength of the Astral team, that they can compound any raw material of the globe. So that definitely is going to give the support in terms of our cost competitiveness. Regarding your second question of what is the market opportunity in the volume, I don't have a handy number with what is the PVC volume number of the country and the CPVC number. But I can say that our market share, as far as the PVC is concerned, it is hardly 4% to 5% kind of country. CPVC, we may be close to about 22 to 23% market share. But volume side, I don't have a handy number with you. But if I will get somewhere, I will definitely share it to you. Anything else left out?
And the inventory gains, if you can quantify, other companies have done that.
I think it is very difficult to quantify, but my rough estimate, I may be wrong also. It will be somewhere around 30 crore kind of inventory gain in this quarter. Roughly, I'm telling you, it may be plus minus 2 crore.
And for the full year, FY21?
Major sale in the previous quarter was CPVC, and that is why you are seeing the heavy growth in the previous quarter. As well as you can see the realization per ton has gone up sizably. That is mainly because CPVC has contributed very heavily to us. And I told in the initial remark, in many of the items we were shortfall also because of the supply constraint was going on in the system and all the vessels were getting delayed. Now touch wood, we have got every raw material in time. Now everything is again back to the normalcy. But otherwise, we one point of time there was a challenge of the raw material also. So CPVC has contributed very, very good in the last quarter. And that is why you are seeing this expansion into the margin as well as the top line. Best part is that in this difficult time also, Astral has maintained their GP margin to 38%, which is the best part. I personally, as a finance person, seeing in my number. And EBITDA will definitely grow with the economy of scale. But maintaining the gross profit margin in this difficult time and passing on at the right time to the market, that is the big achievement our team has. So all credit goes to our marketing team, which has done this excellent job.
Certainly. So what we were looking at is the steady state OPM this company can make, and hence the full year number, inventory gain number for FY21, if you can spell out.
So full year number, very, very, again, I am saying we are not able to calculate, but it should be somewhere around 60 to 65, 70 crore kind of run rate will be there. Because our major chunk of business is coming from CPVC, and CPVC, there was no change in the price. On the contrary, there was a little drop from our side into the price. So because of that, there was no gain into CPVC side, but definitely, PVC might be 60, 70 crore kind of gain should be there. Maybe a few crore plus minus because we are not able to calculate exact number.
Sure, thank you.
And secondly, sir, I can tell you we are more dependent on the local sourcing. So because of that, our raw material or whether finished goods into the PVC basket will be comparatively low than the players who are dependent on import. So the higher gain or higher loss can happen to the people who are more dependent on the import. While we are dependent on local source, either it is the Enplast or maybe you can say the Reliance and all these things. So because of that, our inventory levels are also low. So the moment what price we are getting, we are passing on to the market. So that is why I think our gain will be much, much restricted compared to the other place, I tell you.
Right. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Girish Chaudhary from Spark Capital Advisors Private Limited. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for the opportunity. And firstly, would compliment on the great performance during the quarter and the year. First question on the adhesives business. For the segment, you clocked around 740 crores of revenues this year. But if I see the second half performance and annualize it, it's like more than 900 crores. So just to understand this better, which part of this business is showing a strong uptick? Is it construction chemicals or wood related or maintenance chemicals? Would love to hear your detailed comments on this.
So Sandeepai, will you reply this or should I reply?
I can reply. Yeah. See, every segment has given growth. There is no specific growth of only a few chemistries which have grown. This has been such a good balanced year for us and balanced way of correction and work done that even when we went into details and in our board meeting, everyone was delighted to see equal spread of growth in every segment, in the maintenance, in the epoxies, in the silicones, in the grouts, in the solvent cements, in the cementitious mixtures, in the wood product lines. So it has been a very, very balanced growth, and that is a very good sign of any business, I would say, that if it is a lopsided growth, it is always dangerous, because if something goes wrong on the lopsided growth, your growth falls very fast. But if you have a very balanced growth of all the chemistries, all the products coming in the right percentage, a variation of few 4-5% here or there, it's an excellent business. So every chemistry, every product, every segment we cater to has given us growth. I think this.
Second, I can add something by here that the base part is I think the question was right that if we pick up the second half growth was robust. And if we could have grown upon that run rate, I think we were internally targeting 1,000 crore mark in the FY22. But now the second wave of COVID has come. So we have to see how the pent-up demand is supporting what supported last year. If the same will be repeated, there are high probability that we can touch the 1,000 crore run rate in this year. So it depends on how hard reopening is taking place. Otherwise, yes, we were mentally prepared and geared up. Our team was ready to take that challenge and to touch this landmark number.
I am confident that we will be touching this landmark number, though this 1 or 2 months have been challenging, because now the layout of the business is perfect, reach systems or programs, our way of reporting, our way of billing, our electronic system set in the business, our chemistries, our product line, our demand. So I am 100% confident if 15 days or month goes here or there, but we'll achieve the number by.
Great to hear that. Second question, from the government side, we are seeing massive outlay, specifically Jal Jeevan Mission this year, 50,000 crores, and going ahead also, it's expected to increase. So what are you seeing on ground from this side of the business, and how is a company like Astral placed to take advantage of this kind of increment?
We both are sitting at different place, so sometimes we overlap, don't mind us.
Sure.
Thing is that we are doing good business in government through our reps, and the last 6 months shown a good growth and good pull in the market. The sale has grown. Even in this 2 months also, it has been doing good. And we are working on certain product lines with the Jal Se Nal project, which will be value-added products. We don't want to go into a mass product line and then just rub our bottoms out. that we are working on certain product lines, we have really evaluated products and still goes in these projects. I cannot give you the bigger outlay of these projects due to the competitive reasons, but yes, our eyes are open on this and we are working on it.
Thank you. We would request the current participant to please come back in the question queue for any follow-up questions. The next question is from the line of Sonali Salgaonkar from Jefferies India. Please go ahead.
So thank you for the opportunity and congratulations on a great set of numbers. So my first question is regarding the demand trends. Now you touched upon that saying that may appear to be a little weak. So but dwelling deeper into that, any particular trends you are witnessing in May right now from the urban versus rural point of view as well? And so 54% value growth in April on a two-year basis, was it more because of the underlying demand or market share gains from the unorganized?
So Sonali, I think it is too early to comment about what will happen in the near term to the May 15 days number cannot be the trendsetter for the company for the full year. So I think it is too early for us to give you any guidance or any comment, which may be not right, because we are not expert into the pandemic side going forward, what is going to be there. So, but the way number of cases, as per the reported numbers, are coming continuously down, that had given the hope that the revival will come soon. But very, very difficult to say that it will be surely going to come. So I don't think that will be the right way to tell you that what is that. But overall, the demand is coming from the states which are fully open right now. They are under the restricted lockdown. From that side, demand is still continuing. And we are getting the number from that state. But many of the states are under full lockdown. From there, we are not getting any number. So it is a mixed kind of way things are going on in the first 15 days. But at the same time, April, yes, April numbers were good, but majority of the growth, I can say, was led by the value than the volume. I already communicated in my earlier remarks also that the volume term growth was very big. So, and as such also, if you see the historically also, Astral is delivering close to about 16% growth in the first quarter. So, first quarter is anyway is a lean for us. Whether it is affected by even 10%, hypothetically I consider, then also on an annual basis, it is going to touch with only 1.6% of the volume. So it is not going to affect Astral's number per se for the full year. We were very happy that this thing happened after completing our peak quarter, that is the Q4. So even if something goes wrong in first quarter on an annual number, believe me, it is not going to affect, because first quarter is anyways slow for us. You see the last 10 years, now almost 2007 to till 2021, so almost 14 year history is there, 14 multiplied by 4, so almost 56 quarterly numbers are available. You can see the trend that Q1 is always lean. So I don't think we should give more focus to the Q1 number. Q1 number is not going to affect Astral in any sense.
A fair point. So my second question is, would you like to give any medium-term guidance in the sense 3 to 5 years? Because you just mentioned in your opening remarks that you are targeting to double the size of your top line over the next 5 years. So any growth rate or margin guidance you would like to give at this point of time? And also the CPVC price hikes that you mentioned of 5 to 8%, when were they taken?
So I already replied all this answer in my initial remark. Again, I am repeating if you are not listening to it. So CPVC price, I think across the board industry has taken in the month of April. Some may have tried in March also, but they were not able to implement. Maybe they have implemented in some geography, but April onward, I think across the industry, everyone has taken the price rise into the markets. So this April, I'm telling you. Now coming to your second question was regarding
the guidance, medium term guidance.
So I think in initial remarks, we say that we are aiming to take the company to the double in next 5 years. So indirectly, we are communicating that long-term 15% kind of top-line growth will be there minimum. We are always I can say we are always hungry to grow more. But as a guidance, we are a very conservative, and you have seen the history of last 14 years post listing that Astra management is always believing in force. So we are always conservative in our guidance, and so we are targeting and aiming to be on that level. But at the same time, I communicated the other part also, that now we are sitting with a sizable cash also. So there can be a growth can come from inorganic side also, or maybe a greenfield new project can also come in the coming time, next 3 to 5 years. Now, if that is going to be there, then the growth rate can be even higher than that also. But that is all subjective, because it is very difficult to get a acquisition kind of candidate, because our criteria are very tough. Minimum 20% ROC, it should be leveraging brand Astral, it should be leveraging Astral network, it should be a long-term, highly profitable business, and it should not be a high capex-oriented business. These are the many filters board has defined. So within that filter, getting the business, it is always a challenge. But yes, definitely, we are keeping our eyes open. And if the right opportunity will be there, we will definitely look into that. So if that is the case, then I think we can be growing even higher run rate also.
Thank you. We would request the current participant to please come back in the question queue for any follow-up questions. We would request the participants to please limit your questions to 2 per participant. The next question is from the line of Malik from Equity Securities. Please go ahead.
Thanks for the opportunity and congratulations on very good set of numbers. Just 2 questions from the back. One is, can you just help us understand the because right now the price gap between the CPVC and PVC is not there. In international market, the PVC is right now $1.8 per kg. The PVC could be in the range of around $2.1 or $2.2 per kg. Do you see the shift, and there is more demand for the CPVC from the plumbing as the consumers feel that CPVC is no more than expensive and they start preferring? Have you seen such trend in the past quarter? Or probably will you see this in the coming quarter also?
Yes, Malik, your understanding is absolutely right. I think CPVC is cheaper compared to PVC. The way PVC has gone up compared to that, CPVC has not gone up. So because of that, many players can think to move from PVC to CPVC. And that trend we have seen in the last quarter, and that is why the CPVC volume was very high in the previous quarter, and that trend will continue in the coming time also. That is what we are internally thinking. I think Sandeep can add more into that. Sandeep?
First of all, the international price is not 1.8, it is around 1.5 and 1.45. And the pricing softening will start because things are coming normal in the globe. So, my thinking is that PVC will soften out in next 4 to 6 months. But obviously, CPVC is not so much gone up in this compared to what PVC happened. And obviously, CPVC is a better polymer, better product. And as it is made in copper tube size compared to the ASTM, the per feet running weight of CPVC pipe is less. So the cost of pipe from half, 3/4, and 1 inch is low. So the internal plumbing, there would be an external usage of CPVC obviously going up. Now, when you go to the CPVC again, the advantage which Astral carries doesn't mean CPVC, it makes its own compound, it buys its own polymer, and it has advantage of buying polymer from 2-3 sources. It also gives a major pricing advantage of Astral. And that also additional advantage is being converted into the margins or usage or other programs which we can run, as well as the good aspects and in the projects. So obviously these advantages are carried on for the CPVC to grow more than PVC. And PVC is still at this price also prevailing market. It's come down to certain extent, but not substantially, because if you go in SWR, agri, all these applications, there is no CPVC, there is PVC. Column, etching. only where you fight in CPVC is plumbing against the PVC white. So obviously that market would be more expanded in CPVC.
Got it. Second question and the last one. Hiranand bhai has given some guidance on the adhesive margin, that the aspiration is to reach to 16-17% margin on that side. What could be the similar for the plumbing or the pipe sector, pipe segment, given this year we did 21.5% margin was there compared to 18% in the previous year. Any such guidance or outlook on the margin?
I think, Maulik, margin side pipe, we have already said in the initial remark that the 15-16% is a long-term sustainable margin. But the way Astral is functioning, the way Astral is doing a lot of decentralization work, a lot of value-added products are getting introduced in the system, and we are taking the economy of scale advantage and all these things. So that will take us to the higher margin run rate. So now what will be the higher run rate? I think the time will tell you. But yes, definitely these are the long-term sustainable kind of margin. And it depends on the polymer trend also. We have never ever said that we will be able to maintain 23, 22 kind of margin.
Sure.
Because these are the abnormal margins which include the element of inventory gain also. So we have to understand that part also, and we have to remove that also from the system. And secondly, whenever there is a polymer high, then you know that the percentage terms, your margin will always go up because your fixed overheads are always fixed. And your top line growth, then your percent, if you divide with them, then definitely your core expenditure will be low. So because of that, I think margins are very, very high, which definitely will not be able to sustain 22%, 23% kind of rate. But yes, we will see that we should be between 16 to 18, 90% kind of run rate. That will be a good achievement for us. But yeah, 15 to 16% is a long-term sustainable. Additional, whatever we are taking the steps and all, whatever that benefit will keep coming to us, we will keep increasing to that level. But this will be the minimum benchmark we have set in the organization.
Okay. And just, you mentioned in that the April 19 to April 21, the growth in pipe segment for the April 21 was 1%, right? Volume growth?
I don't remember exactly 1%, but it should be somewhere in the lower single digit, yes.
Okay, great. Thank you. Stay safe and wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Kunal Lakhani from CLSA. Please go ahead.
Hi, good evening. So you mentioned earlier that you know your PVC market share is about 4 to 5%, and CPVC is around 22 to 23%. So the market share hasn't really changed significantly in the last 1 year or so. So just wanted to understand that you have been mentioning about the consolidation happening in the industry, but it doesn't get reflected in the market share. That's my question one. And my second question is in terms of your guidance of 15% top line over the next 5 years annually. Would you break that up into volume guidance and realization guidance? The reason why I'm asking is this, because if you look at our volume growth in 2021 is 3%, and largely the top line growth has been driven by realization and pricing. So just wanted that breakup of like 15% top line growth that we are targeting in terms of volume growth.
So this 15%, we have given a generalized guidance that we will be, with the caveat that there are a lot of new activities happening in the organization that will take the growth on a higher side. So that is not a bad 15% is a fixed guidance from the management side. So this is the minimum which we are targeting, and then there are a lot of the lever available with the management, and which I already explained in my initial remarks also. And we have put up these all levers into the presentations also. If that will support, then the growth can be even much, much higher than what is that level. Secondly, your remarks of the market share, I think you should also understand that the country level, the polymer market has degrown by 15 to 17% last year. So we should not forget that the market was compressed. And under that situation, Astral was able to grow at a 3 to 4% volume. When the market is compressed by 15-17% and we are growing at a 3-4%, that means indirectly we are getting the market share. So, and secondly, this industry number, I have put an approximate number, may not be a right number with me. So I don't think in any sense we can say that we are not getting the market share. We are definitely getting the market share. Otherwise, we can't grow in this degrowing market, which is degrowing at a very higher rate. So we have to consider the market conditions also. Based on that, I think we should take the decision. So I am quite confident that we are definitely taking the market share, and that is reflected in the numbers also.
No, let me get into this.
Sure.
Last fiscal, we have done excellently well in PVC compared to the smaller players also and everyone. And we have, in spite of not doing anything in April, May, have given this number of growth. You can imagine if you divide this growth number by just 10 months, then the growth would be even much, much better in double digits. So we are focused and we are working and we would be growing in PVC. We don't want to just focus and do PVC. That's all. PVC is a product with which Astral is born. So it will be obviously being a lead product of Astral. But PVC is not a product which is in the second category or not being considered. Why are we going with Bhubaneswar plant? Why are we putting PVC machines in Aurangabad and Sangli? Sangli already 4 machines are operational. Aurangabad 4 or 5 machines will be operational in 2 months. So obviously even in north we are planning in Uttaranchal to get into this. So everywhere our focus is to extend in all polymers. PVC, yes, obvious. CPVC, yes, obvious. PPP also, and in the water tank business. It's coming in water tank business, yes, obvious. And there are a lot of other plants which are there for the growth of the polymers, products, reach and margin, which we can not unfold every strategy in an open platform. Being watched by every manufacturer is looking what Astral is doing and what Astral is saying, what Astral wants to do, and what Astral says has been repeated in the echoes of every people. So we don't want to echo our own policies with other people and then get that echo back to us. So yes, obviously we are focusing on everything which is there in the business. And with the margin added products, as there was a question where why you can sustain a margin, because we are focusing also on margin added products. We are focusing on a lot of product lines where we know that we can sustain a better margin and we can sustain our EBITDA margin. But a lot of these strategies can not be unfold, but the numbers will unfold and say about the things in the coming years and coming quarters. And obviously our dreams would be high next 5 years to reach a goal which we have set for ourselves to a number of to the top line and the bottom line for both adhesive and the pipe business.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. All the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Abhishek Ghosh from BSP Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir. Thanks for the opportunity. So just a couple of questions. We hear a lot of the unorganized players having faced a lot of issues during the crisis because of supply chain and other things. Now with things kind of normalizing, do you believe they kind of coming back or have they kind of gone for good? If you can just get your comments on that.
Actually, in second wave,
yes, sir.
They are more affected actually. And if your ship is shaken too much, it takes its own long time to come back to the level. So it is obvious that it is not going to be so easy and so fast for the unorganized players and the smaller players to come back at that thrust and force. And they, lot of them are almost in the capital, in the have issues with their working capital cycle. And a lot of them have issues with their production facilities almost shut down. So obviously, we wish that this should happen. I would not, as a person, as an industrialist, wish this is a good sign and anybody should face this in the future or any time. But obviously, for reasons, these are what has happened, and I think this will continue. It is not good to bounce back that.
Abhishek, I can add what Sandeep bhai has said, that a few of them definitely will come back. It is not that 30-35% unorganized players are, that they all will die. But sure. Hypothetically, I am telling you, even 20% or 25% of that will go away, then 10,000 crore plus market opportunities are there with the unorganized players. So 10 to 12,000 is when is with them. Even if the 20-25% will go away from the system, that itself is going to open up a big opportunity for the organized players.
Sure.
And never,
sure,
ever going to happen that 100% will die. That will never happen. Even after 10 years also, some unorganized player will be there in the system.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that's very helpful. Thank you so much, sir. So the other question is, if you can just help us understand the increase in the touch points for the adhesive segment, if you can just help us with some quantification of that, what is the touch point today and what are you doing to kind of increase it in percentage terms, that'd be helpful.
So touch point, actually what has happened, that earlier we were working on a certain data bank which marketing people were sharing with us. So, but that was not an authenticated data bank with us. But now I think we have developed our own programs, and now we are tracking it, the down the line data and all these things. So now we are getting the authenticated number. Right now we are quoting in our presentation 130,000 touch points. But I think it should be more in the system. But because now we are consolidating all this number, I think hopefully in next 1 or 2 quarters, we'll be getting the right number. What is there? Because now every schemes and everything is connected with that program. So because of that, we'll be having the exact number with us. That will going to help us also in our decision making also, and give us the exact numbers also. So hopefully maybe 1 or 2 quarters down the line, we will be able to tell you exact number. But right now we have quoted number around 130,000 to 140,000 number in our presentation, but actual number should be more. As far as pipe is concerned, I think there 33,000 to 34,000 kind of touch points are there.
Thank you. We would request the current participant to please come back in the question queue for any follow-up questions. We would also request the participants to please limit your questions to one per participant. The next question is from the line of Madhav Marda from Fidelity International. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir, good evening and thank you so much for your time. I just wanted to understand on the new launches that we spoke about, the valve unit and the aluminium CPVC pipes. What could be the opportunity here in terms of the opportunity size in India? And also just curious to understand, can valves and the aluminium CPVC pipe, is that an export opportunity also in the future?
In the size opportunity, just give us 1 quarter, we can give you a percent approximate size of the market also, obviously. Because we are not, there is a market, there is a size. We were, when we stopped manufacturing of this composite pipe 6 years back, we had reached a monthly sale of around 3 to 4 crores. But that was a very costly product at that time. What actually we have developed and made is much cost effective and gives the same results and better results. So we'll give you an exact size of the market in just 1 quarter. And valves, obviously, yeah, we'll give you a rough estimate. Already in the industrial segment, we are growing. And we are selling valves around 70-80 crores, and we'll give you exact size of that. Exactly, it's a rough estimate. The third point you are saying, yes, both have export opportunity. And we'll be exploring opportunity for it. And it has more export opportunity than even Indian opportunity, especially valves. And even by the similar export opportunity.
Okay. And the export opportunity for valves and aluminium CPVC pipe, is that something we would like to explore in the near term, or is it going to be more 2-3 years later once we've...
Once the range is over, we can explore in valve. You cannot go with half range. So once the range is over in next 1 year or so, we'll obviously explore and composite in next two quarters. After two quarters, we'll start exploring.
Okay, got it. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Sneha Taldeja from Edelweiss Securities. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir, and congratulations on great set of numbers. So just two questions from my end. What is the breakup of other expenses, or why the other expenses from this particular quarter is a bit higher? And secondly, what is your CAPEX guidance for the next 2 years?
I think as far as the CAPEX is concerned, we are targeting roughly about 140 to 150 crore this year. And next year will be close to about 100 crore. Now, coming to your second question of other expenditure, I think last quarter was the abnormal quarter for us because we launched our new brand ambassador at WeSing. So because of that, we spent a sizable money for fees of Mr. Ranveer Singh. Secondly, making the aid film, because that is also a costly affair to make an aid film. And we have made a 3-4 different film. It was not only one film. So we spent on the making of the film charges also. And plus launch campaign. We completely sponsored the India-England series. And that has given us a good mileage. And secondly, we had a sizable budget lying with us. And because we cannot shy away doing the branding. Otherwise, we are going to affect our brand for a longer term basis. So we were sitting on a sizable budget with us. So we were a little bit generous in spending into the branding activity. So that also was there. So because of all these things, other costs have shot up, but that is not a permanent kind of feature. After doing that also, our annual branding budget was, compared to previous quarter year, it was low. So we are always focused and very clear that our budget, whatever being given to the team, should be strictly followed. It is not that we can change our budget. But yes, the timing of quarterly basis may be changed because of the event. But otherwise, on an annualized basis, we always try to maintain what budget we have given to the team.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Rahul Agarwal from Incred Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, good evening. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. And congratulations, Hiranandji and Sandeepji, on a very good set of results. A lot of questions got answered. Just one question. From fiscal 17 to 21, I'm seeing there's a consistent decline in overall debtor days. You know, the receivable management has been amazing. Overall working capital, obviously, you know, I'm looking at a core number, inventory plus debtor minus creditors, gone down from 41 to 27 days YOY. You know, that is also great. I just wanted to understand, is this driven by pipes or adhesives? That is one. And, you know, if you could guide us on the future of this, like where does the overall working capital cycle stabilize? You know, obviously, fiscal 21 was, you know, a very great year for working capital for most companies here. But if you could just help us understand working capital better and where does it stabilize, it would be helpful. Thank you.
I think the overall performance was excellent in pipe division, followed by Reginova, that is Indian adhesive division. Overseas division, on the contrary, little bit inch up in the working capital cycle. So 2-3 days have more in all side, whether it was inventory or receivable. So overseas side, there was no improvement in the working capital cycle. They have maintained with the 3-4 days plus minus. But definitely in the Indian operation, both adhesive as well as pipe, both has performed excellent, I can say. And going forward also, I think we are targeting that we will be more or less 5 days plus minus from whatever the level right now you are seeing. But on a quarterly basis, it can be little bit plus minus. Like now, hypothetically, this quarter, the volumes will be little lower because of this pandemic effect. So in that case, your inventory level may go up because we were working on it. 20-25% kind of volume growth trajectory, and now all of a sudden this challenge comes, then naturally little bit inventory will go away. Again, the pent-up demand will come, then the Q2 again it will go down. But on an average, I'm telling you, we will be plus minus 5 days what you are seeing in the current year's full year number.
So full year ended at 18 days. So should I assume like 25 days is a steady state number overall working
capital? Maximum you can consider 25 days.
Thank you. We would request the current participant to please come back in the question queue for any follow-up questions. The next question is from the line of Sagar Jethwani from Philip Capital. Please go ahead.
Great set of numbers, sir, and impressive growth. Sir, I have quick three questions. In piping segments, whom are we taking market share from? Is it just from the unorganized market, or maybe you can name any player? And the second question is, how much is the export contribution do you see in next 3 to 4 days? Third, if you can quickly help us with export margins and export receivable days. Thank you.
So I think it is not fair to give any organized player's name that whose market share we are taking. That is injustice to everyone. So we will not be able to share the name of whom we are taking the market share. But definitely unorganized market share we are definitely taking. So that is across all the industry. Every organized players are trying to take the unorganized portion. Now coming to your export side, I think export side still is very, very limited presence. So now with this addition of new product, like Sandeep bhai has rightly said, that PVC aluminum has a good potential for export, wall has a good potential for export. Now our adhesive division is picking up for the export, because many products are such there, we can also export. So going forward, we may increase our focus into the export front, and we may increase our export, because right now export as a percentage of the sale is hardly anything. So, but definitely, yes, there is a huge scope available in future. And definitely, we will see that now we can keep a specialized people over there. Right now, already some people are we have appointed and they are taking care. That's why export revenue is going up. But still, it is not up to the mark. So, we will see that now we can increase the strength over there and we can grow these revenue at a very, very fast run rate, because still our base is very, very negligible and scope is there. And now with this new addition of the product, the scope will be wider. So definitely we will try and see that we can grow the market share into the export side also. And export side receivable, I think amount is very negligible, so hardly anything will be there. And majority of our export is either advance or through LC. None of the party whom we give clean credit. So it is 100% secure. And that is why you can see in the balance sheet, which is going to be shortly published and presentations and all, our more than, I think, 90 days of receivable are hardly 3 crore, 2 crore rupees as a company as a whole. So 2-3 crore rupees is nothing looking to the size of that. So we don't allow, and we are very, very serious about our this cycle, and we don't allow anybody. Otherwise, we can have done a much, much better volume if we start giving the credit terms to our distributor, or maybe quoting to the direct projects, or maybe giving supply to the government. We can grow even much, much faster rate, but we have maintained a discipline in the organization that we don't want a higher growth. We want the growth which is the consistent. See, this is very important what Astral philosophy is there. We don't want overnight growth. We want the growth which is consistent. And that is why you see the day we have got it listed from 2007 until today, 14 years, you see on a year-on-year basis we are growing. So we always believe in consistency. We don't want 25, 30%, 40% kind of growth. We want 15%, we are happy, but we should see that it should be consistently maintained. And that is why we, every time, personally, I am also telling every investor, if you want to compound your money, Astral is the best company for you. A short-term kind of gain, Astral is not a good company to put money. So consistency is very important for us, and we always stick to that, and we are educating every our team member also into that front only.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Achal Lohade from JM Financial. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity, sir, and congratulations for great numbers. My question was, in terms of, we have seen we adding, acquiring Rex, we acquiring, facility in Aurangabad. I'm talking about specifically the pipe segment here. So, in terms of acquisition, or do you see opportunities around, as you kind of hinted, we could have 1,000 crores kind of a cash balance over the next couple of years. So in that situation, how do you look at deploying that from an inorganic growth perspective? Will that be more in the pipe segment or adhesive segment?
I think basically inorganic growth is obviously any organization which is sitting on cash and which is an opportunity which comes to its door will obviously grab, and we have done that. As of now, nothing on the table, but as of now, opportunities come and go, and we rightly evaluate. There is a future, there is a margin, there is a product line, there is a synergy, there is an opportunity. We will always keep looking at it. It is not that we won't be keep looking at it. But wherever we have taken this step of getting into a new segment, getting into a new business, getting into a new product line, getting into this industry, you can see our track record of all acquisition is put them online, put them on growth, put them in our culture and do our best. And it has been now which we are tuned to. And obviously, we will be exploring such opportunities in this four wall of the construction industry. That is what we would like to remain in this four wall of the construction industry. And Astral has built its own brand, its own, it is today having a lot of recognition as the best brand, as the most powerful brand, or many, many recognitions are there. You will see in the presentation today. And the best part of Astral is, which it was not there maybe 6 years back today, Astral has its own complete range of technology, complete range of product line, complete indigenous technologies, whether silent pipe is made, whether composite, CPVC, compound, fire pipe, industrial pipe, PVC, and even the column pipe, we have a new technology. So Astral has its own technologies, it has all its own brands. Astral does not have any brand which is owned and technology from someone else. It has its own product line, it has its own technology, and it will keep doing the growth path in its own technology, product line in piping, adhesives, and by the inorganic parts also. So that is what my vision carries on.
Thank you. We take the last question from the line of Sujit Jain from ASK Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
So just one question. You mentioned about the gap between PVC and CPVC price in terms of the current rates per kg, what they would be, so that gives us a sense as to the reduction of the gap between the two.
So like PVC pre-COVID was roughly about 70 rupees a kg, which has gone up to a peak level of 135 kind of level, and now 4 rupees drop is there, so around 130-131 rupees is there. So that price rise was there. While CPVC, there was no price rise except this 5-6% or 7% every company has taken in the month of April. So that kind of gap has reduced, I can say, in the system.
Thank you. That was the last question. I would now like to hand the conference over to the management for closing comments.
Thank you everyone for this opportunity. I would always like to close saying that be safe, take care of your families, take care of yourselves, and still we have to work and still we have to grow. So we have to accept the reality, accept the challenge, take care of ourselves, get vaccinated, and we have to get back to our work. And we are back on work, and we hope everyone gets back to work and things keep normalized. We pray to God, we appreciate the steps taken by the several state governments and the central governments, and we'll be back to business in short. At the same time, we thank you for your trust in us and believing in us and giving us the opportunity today to present our Q4 result and joining us in this call and the annual results also. And we will surely look forward to again talking to you after Q1 results, and if time permits and if things permit, at the half year results, we would like to come down to Bombay and have a conference and meet you in person. That is what I am dreaming for. But stay healthy and take care of yourself. Best wishes to everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for joining this call. If any questions are unanswered from the participant, I think you can call me anytime. My mobile is always available 24/7 for you people. And post this presentation, if you have any question or any doubt, then also you can call me tomorrow, because this presentation will be now uploaded shortly, maybe in a couple of hours or so. I will try whatever early I can do, and will be in touch with you. Thank you very much. Thank you, and bye bye.
Thank you. On behalf of Edelweiss Personal
Limited. And thank you to Edelweiss team for hosting this conference. Thank you, Praveen.
Thank you, Edelweiss team.
Thank you. On behalf of Edelweiss Broking Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your line.